On Monday night, after President Donald J. Trump delivered a speech on Afghanistan, Philip Rucker, the Washington Post bureau chief for the White House, wrote on Twitter that he saw in that address a new President Trump acknowledging a flip-flop and talking about gravity of office, history, substance. He was the long-awaited pivotal presidential behavior many had sought from Trump. Then came Tuesday. On Tuesday evening, Trump came to Phoenix, Arizona, for a campaign rally, disregarding the call by many, including that city mayor, Greg Stanton, to stay away, speaking for more than an hour to a large and friendly crowd. Trump complained about the media, taunted liberal protesters and malign Arizona's two senators, both of whom are Republican, in place of compassion. He chose selfishness, in place of seriousness. Fedulan, trending Trump and human rights U.S. expect to withhold up to $290 million in aid to Egypt in doing so. Trump pro definitively that he had no interest in being presidential, and that why he enjoyed the spectacle that is the campaign trail. He has little use for the trapping of the presidency itself, as with previous pivot. This one lasted all of 24 hours. Trump wanted the blessing Western Sun to dispel the gloom that has turned over his presidency. Largely because of Trump's own lack of discipline, his troubling response to the extremist violence in Charlottesville, Virginia, with climate tree light, led to denunciation by congressional Republican and the dissolution of corporate advisory council, supporter fear that the Phoenix rally would only further inflame tension. In particular, if he pardon former Maricopa County Sheriff Joe Appel, what recently been convicted of contempt of court charge, stemming from policing practices that were deemed discriminatory of Latinos. Trump didn't pardon Appel, though he strongly suggested he would do so shortly, but he also showed no willingness to unite the nation or offer the kind of healing message one expects from the president at a time of tragedy. Instead, he railed against the truly dishonest people in the media, who he said misrepresented his three statements on Charlottesville, two of which suggested leftist counter-protesters were as responsible as white nationalists for the violence that took place there last weekend. Don't miss student who posed with Confederate flag in Charlottesville kicked out of Christian College. Trump also noted that he had a resident in Charlottesville. Speaking about Charlottesville at length, Trump showed little solemnity, nor any evident understanding of how decline the event has shaken the nation. His primary concern was the media treatment of Trump himself. He lamented CNN's firing of Jeffrey Lord, a conservative commentator who used a Nazi slogan on Twitter, only later, and in passing, did the president mention the young woman killed by a white nationalist in Charlottesville, and why a campaign rally is by definition a nakedly political event. It hard to imagine another sitting president engaging in such unseemly, divisive rhetoric. At one point, he had the crowdy chanting CNN sub to his obvious pleasure, fighting were the elite, they not the elite, he said during the attended anti-media diatribe. He also claimed that he went to better school than they did and mocked ABC News host George Stephanopoulos for his diminutive size. The president complained that cameras had been turned off during his speech. That was not true. Most popular Trump Arizona rally start time, live stream and everything else you need to know about the president's speech while the rally may have happened. Trump bet it could not have done much to expand his support. Trump has apparently come to believe that he can win re-election by solely appealing to disenfranchised working class white. This is a view shared by his chief political strategist, Stephen K. Bannon, who left his post at the White House last week. They are trying to take away our history and our heritage, Trump said, clearly indicating that his sympathy lay with those who want Confederate statutory preserved. He also promised to recapture our dynasty, a vague phrase that could be interpreted as having white nationalist overtone. Despite his denunciation of the media, the Republican establishment and other support member of the ruling elite, Trump returned to Washington this week an increasingly isolated figure, with virtually no accomplishment to his name and little interest in crafting the kind of compromise that might give him the perfect resort win. Not my president, when the cry of the anti-Trump resistance in the day following his election last November, increasingly, Trumpsin to agree, why he is happy pandering to his bed with net with rhetoric and ratio grievong, governing all American just it his thing, more from Newsweek.